really I was not emotionally there for John. And so, let's see. I'll fast forward a little bit. Then 2008, our lives were turned upside down when his father decided to go with someone. And they were supposed to be doing a burglary, and it turned into something worse. So he ended up being taken from us, and our family has never been the same, really. But I quit that night when they came and looked for him. I quit. And I stayed quit for probably about a year and a couple of months. And then I decided one beer. What's one beer gonna do? Not thinking that I have the addictive personality, that I've had problems with substances in the past. Either it's gonna lead me back to my drug of choice, or I was just gonna not be able to function on alcohol. I wasn't a very good functioning alcoholic at all. I wasn't worth a crap. I didn't want to do anything. But that's when I started, and then found out my dad, after losing Cody, then found my dad was sick, and he had cancer, and he had an aneurysm in his brain and behind his heart. And I just slowly started having to drink more and more. I remember one night Susan caught me drinking. She said, "You know exactly where this is going to lead you. You know you can't do this kind of stuff." And I mean, she was correct. She was only looking out for my well-being and John's. Of course, I bucked. I didn't, I was like, "Nah, not me." So eventually I ended up moving out because of my drinking. I didn't want anybody telling me I couldn't drink. And I didn't want anybody watching me telling me I couldn't drink, Me and her had it out pretty bad. And that's when I turned to this friend that I had met at work. By this time I had gotten a job at John Bleakley RV. And I would drink on the job, actually. I think so. Yeah, lunch break. Couldn't go. Got to the point where I'd have to have one on lunch break. Not very wise, especially when you're supposed to be on top of RVs washing them. Not wise at all. But I managed to meet my ex, the one that I was with when I came into the rooms that I had the biggest problem with. I met him, and then that's when I decided to move out of Susan's and get out on my own, and I started working with his cousin at a nightclub in Atlanta. That relationship got damaged because of alcohol. I got heavier into my drinking because of the job that I was at. And then I found out I was pregnant. And I had a miscarriage, I believe 12 weeks. And I had to go to all those doctor's appointments. And I was actually very heartbroken over that. I quit drinking and everything. It took me about 8 weeks to quit after I found out, but it was too late. So then I picked up drinking again. And I continued to drink very heavily. And then I found out I was pregnant again. So by this time, I was wasn't allowed to work at the two jobs that I had because I had got me a cover-up job for my first job. Yeah. But it was a bar. Yep. Way to go. Right up my alley. Drinking half the customer's beer before I get to the table wasn't that good. So, yeah. And then, of course, they enabled me. They would all put like a little circle around me and let me drink beer. So, needless to say, I don't even know how I've made it home. Got pulled over several times. Butts County, they would either escort me home or they just let me go. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how that happened. I don't even know how that works. Because I know at one point I was blowing a .06, ran off the road, had an open container, fled the scene of the accident, then lied about the accident to the cop when he asked me if I ran off the road somewhere back there. I said, no, sir. He's like, why do you have a wrench hanging out from under your car? I was like, okay, maybe just a little. And he was like, uh-huh, get out of the car. So I step out of the car, give me a breathalyzer. He's like, you have any open containers in the car? Anything in the car that we should know about? And I was like, no. And I wouldn't let him search. Well, needless to say, after all that hoorah, they called the K-9 unit and everything. They told me if I could find a ride, somebody to drive the car away, that I can go.
Wow.
Oh, really? I can go? Is this a trick? And they're like, no, you can go. Find somebody to drive your car, you can go. Wow, I would say Butts County was my biggest enabler. You know? So I was like, okay, great. So I called my ex, well, boyfriend at the time, and he left John and his daughter over with the neighbor. We called her grandma. When I moved in, she was like, just call me grandma. And I was like, okay, grandma. Yeah, I wasn't a good influence on her either. We kind of got her drunk one day. Feel bad for that. But, so they let me leave. They let me get away. No ticket either. I didn't even get a ticket. But by this time, it was time to sell the car. Because now my car has probably been on the radar for a minute. And, you know, DUI accident in it and stuff. And I was just like, yeah, it's time to get rid of the car. So I got me another car. Yeah. I couldn't test drive it, though, because I was drunk. So I let my friend test drive it. Good old car. That car was a piece of crap. Paid way too much for it. That's, you know, one of the prices you pay. It's expensive. It was expensive beer too. So I wasn't able to work. I was pregnant. And I was losing my apartment. And John, bless his heart, he was like, don't worry, mommy. He's like, I got money in the bank. And he was only like 4 at the time. Yeah, 4 at the time. He was in pre-K. Yeah. And he swore but no, he was going to help me. He said, I got money in the bank, mommy. It's okay. You don't need a boyfriend. He was telling me from this big, mommy, you don't need a boyfriend. No. Yeah, mommy, at the time, thought I did. Guess what? Hold on. didn't need him. I thought I needed him. So he moves me in, because I'm losing my apartment, and he moves me into this wonderful condemned trailer that looks like it was actually an old meth house. We weren't supposed to be living there. But the way they did it was they rented the property to us, and the house, the trailer was on there, and said, hey, whatever you do with the trailer's on you. How we got water and electricity, I don't know, but half the time the bill wasn't paid. So, really, I guess that didn't count. Johnny and I were having problems, major problems. I was pregnant when he moved me in. I hated everybody around there. And I was I was terrible. I was mean. And every now and again, he would let me have a glass of wine. Well, he'd leave the bottle with me. Yeah, so when he'd come in there after his was gone, he'd be like, hey, where's that bottle of wine? I'll just burp and point. There you go, right over there. And so it was a big struggle. It was stressful. Moved out. Well, no, take it back. I had my son, Gavin, my middle one. I had him. I almost had him on the side of 1941. He was coming a little too quick, but we were staying in that condemned trailer. The water got cut off the day that we were coming home from the hospital. Good times. I tried. I started drinking again immediately, but I tried to have my children there at that condemned trailer like a moron. With no air conditioning. Finally, after about 3 months of it, I decided that not the place for my children. I did one of the hardest things I had to do, and this was after I'd already let John go stay with his Nana. But I handed Gavin over to my ex's mom, not knowing that it was going to be hard from there on out to have a relationship with him, especially after I found out I was pregnant again. So we moved out shortly after I found out, after we sent Gavin to stay with his mother. That's when I started drinking even more. It's when the shakes and everything started and twitching if I didn't have alcohol. I would be so scared that when I didn't have alcohol, that it would keep me drinking. I had to have my next drink. Lost my mom, my birth mother, in 2012. That was a big shock. I wasn't expecting that. It was very unexpected. But then I found out I was pregnant again, so we ended up moving out of the trailer park. But I got arrested one time before we moved out of there. I got arrested for battery. It got dismissed because somebody was on my property and they taunted me. But what I went to jail for was my roommate because I broke his nose. He got in the way. Yeah. He was always getting in the way of the fights. I'm like, that's why you always get hit. But he said he didn't want to press charges, but the state picked it up. Good old Union County. So they picked it up, put me in there for 48 hours because it was weekend and I couldn't do anything. They let me out on OR. And then I found out I was pregnant with Silas after all that. So then the following weekend, Johnny went to jail. And then the following weekend, we both almost went to jail. That's when we said, okay, enough of this neighborhood, it's time to go. So we moved out. We moved into a company house because he worked for a Japanese steakhouse and he was a hibachi chef. We moved in there. I wasn't really supposed to be living there because I didn't work for Kuma. Later on down the road I did. But we spent a bunch of time arguing, very unhappy. I wanted family to work. I wanted my kids back, and she wanted my kids. So me and her didn't get along too well. Me and him didn't get along too well. We were just toxic for each other. I know that now. Then I thought I couldn't breathe without him. We were just toxic for each other. I'm gonna fast forward a little bit onto getting on into recovery. So the last time that I had gotten arrested, it was for assault. We were still staying at the company house. It was right before, shortly, a couple months before I moved out. But it put me into the program because I was on probation. Actually, I was on probation for my DUI that I got when I first moved to the company house. They don't play like